Good morning. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter. We congratulate the girls and boys who will be making their first Holy Communion at today's Mass. These children and their parents will lead our May crowning procession. The children will carry flowers to Mary, and she will be crowned by Senior Stephanie Salto. The crown bearer is Kelly Miller. In the bulletin you received today is an insert sheet with today's songs. For our procession, we will sing the first three songs. Lord, we bring to you our children, Immaculate Mary and Holy Mary, now we crown you. Please stand now for our procession.
Scriptures. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
Yeah. first reconciliation certificate. We thank you for your forgiving grace. We bring the wheat, which is used in making bread. We bring grapes used to make the wine. We bring bread to show that you fed the multitude and that you always take care of us. We offer our love to God by bringing the water, wine, and host to be changed into Jesus, the one who started the church.
I die for thee.
You have 5 girlfriends.
Mm-hmm.
Two
girlfriends. Come on, Ben, let's see.
That's easy, I know both of them.
Yes, you do have to.
Thank you.
My name is George Smith, and I'm one of the four instructors who spent the last 2 weeks with the class participants. What I would like to do is tell you a little bit about what we've done for the last 2 weeks before you see the show, and I think maybe that will help you enjoy and appreciate the incredible effort that your children have put out over the last 2 weeks. Our goal at the beginning of this workshop is that every student leaves with some specific skills in voice and movement and acting that they can take and apply to any theatrical situation, no matter what it is. So our goal is not so much to help them put together an incredibly good show, but to make sure that they've learned some skills before they leave. As it turns out, once they've learned skills, they're capable of putting on an incredibly good show, which you are about to see. During the first week, we concentrated very heavily on the skills. Jason Held, who may or may not poke his head out through here, worked with all of the students on mind skills, creative movement, using their bodies as instruments to express themselves on stage. I worked with the voice-related skills, helping them to use specific methods to get volume in their voice, to get clear diction so they're more understandable, and also to use their voices, again, to express themselves better on stage. Lisa Anderson, who is with us for the first week, combined the voice and movement skills in her improvisation workshop and storytelling class. And it was in those classes that the children began to develop the ideas and the stories that eventually, by the end of the week, became the show. Everything you see today began with the ideas from a classroom. So not only are they performing the stories, they also created them. During the second week, Shawnee Langworthy joined us. She helped the kids to recreate the stories that they had worked on in the previous week for the stage. She worked with them developing the characters and polishing every detail in all areas of the performance that you're going to see. 2 weeks is a really short length of time to take on the kind of project that they've done. And we want it to be a lot of fun for them, but out of necessity, it's also a great deal of work. And I feel that this group has done a very good job. They've learned a lot about self-discipline. They've learned a lot about cooperating on a project. And those also are skills that we hope that they will take with them. I know that you're going to be impressed with the stories, and I also think you'll be very proud of what your children have done. After the performance, Lisa Anderson will have a question and answer session where you can ask anything about the performance or about the creation of the workshop and how it got started, anything you might want to know. Hopefully we'll be able to come up with an answer for you. So, my last thing to say is I hope you enjoy the show this afternoon.
Thank you.
choir began to smile, the people began to cheer,
and the man became very hot.
Although the people enjoyed the light, they missed the peacefulness of the darkness too. The people realized that they needed the fire and the darkness.
And to this day, we still have day and night.
Thank you. This summer. Next, we'll take you to camp where kids are learning the love of theater. We'll be right back.
You can see three people just dropped
down. Minnesota Summer Camp, Arts Camp. Kids from around the area took the stage at Leroy High School for the matinee performance put on by the Southeast Minnesota Educational Cooperative Service Unit and the Mask Youth Theater and School. The performance was the culmination of a two-week-long camp where the kids learned theater skills and had fun showing them off.
I really enjoyed it, and I liked how we got to learn lines and how they taught us the voice, how to project your voice.
We put our ideas together and took the best ones, and that's how we made our show.
The camp ended today, but many kids say they'll be back next year to do it all again. Some surprises.
We are tied at two, opening minutes. This first semifinal game from the Omni in Atlanta. Lamb inside to Heidi Gillingham. Good pressure on her. Double team now.
The Lady Raiders would like to see Vanderbilt take the outside shot and beat them from the outside and get the rebound. They're going to have to keep Vanderbilt off the offensive board. And there's an out-of-bounds to the Lady Raiders. But good defense that time in denying Vanderbilt from getting the ball inside. They don't want to get beat early inside and try and force the Commodores to shoot the ball from the outside.
This is Kirkland, number 21, working her way to the corner.
Good defense by Vanderbilt. You can see Texas Tech very much trying to look to get the ball inside. There's a penetration right there, but Vanderbilt is so big.
Steal by Rhonda Blades. The foul, and she misses. Ball comes back.
Vanderbilt can shoot the ball from the outside. Here we see them on the defensive end, and the penetration by Kirkland, and you see the reach in by Blades for the steal. Their second turnover.
Johnson and Scott in the backcourt for the Red Raiders. Scott for three. Let's go.
Big rebound by Klinger. Vanderbilt comes away with it, but Texas Tech, they've got to hit their shot early, and that time, wide open, Stephanie Scott, and misses that three-point shot.
Girard taking it away from Klinger.
Nice.
Gillingham, good move inside, and a nice feed for Missy Lamb. 4-2, Vanderbilt lead.
Good quick pass inside, Tim, and Gillingham, what she's worked on is that little jump hook.
And Gillingham rebounding, she averages 7.